a bungee jumper, a flying manta ray, an oil slick. Those rainbow colours on the cloud are called iridescence. It might look a little bit like a rainbow on a cloud, but the way the colours are created for rainbows and for iridescence are completely different.
Rainbows are created by a process called refraction, but iridescence is caused by diffraction.
When light diffracts, it gets bent around very small objects. The light bends or diffracts slightly on the outside of things like water droplets and ice particles in a cloud. Diffraction scatters light waves into a ring-like pattern of colours around the droplets. When you have a whole lot of light scattering around the outside of a cloud filled with tiny water droplets, that light spreads out into the iridescent colours. The scattering means that the colours don't usually appear in neat bands like a rainbow. Sometimes the bands of colour will be wave-like, but usually the pattern is uneven and the colours are randomly spread out. Also, because the light waves are diffracting, you'll get to see amazing colours like hot pinks and teals. The iridescence is sometimes compared to colours on a soap bubble, or a peacock's feather, or a Christmas beetle. Usually the colours won't be as bright as that though. They'll be a little bit fainter or pastel. Diffraction happens when the droplets are tiny, like really, really tiny, less than a micron wide. How small is a micron?
Take a human hair. That's about 100 microns wide. And a water droplet is just 1 micron wide.
And as well as being very small, all the droplets in the cloud need to be around about the same size. That's more likely to happen when a cloud is brand new, because the droplets all start out about the same size. They haven't had enough time to grow or bump into each other and coalesce.
Iridescence is also more vivid when there aren't too many droplets in the cloud. Fewer droplets makes it more likely that the light wave will diffract off only one droplet.
When there are fewer droplets in a cloud, it's usually a lot thinner. That's why you'll see iridescence at the edges of clouds, where there are less droplets, or in semi-transparent clouds. The kinds of clouds that iridescence occurs most often in are ones that are high up in the atmosphere, like altocumulus, cirrocumulus, and cirrus clouds. They're often made of ice. Of course, you need light as well. So the closer the sun is to the cloud, the stronger the iridescent colours. Now that bright light right in your eyeballs means that it can be hard to see iridescence. So a good tip is to shield the sunlight from your eyes and then make sure you can still see the cloud. Ah, that's better. Beautiful, isn't it?